I'm Vanessa Harrop, and on today's episode, we're going to be hunting mountain goat with Luke Vince in northern British Columbia. Now, I'm sure some of you have had the problem of having that one animal you just can't get. Mine is mountain goat. I've gone on 4 previous hunts, none of them successful, not due to human error, all totally bad luck. I've gone through hikes where no mountain goat can be found in my area, bug infested, gone up mountain after mountain, 10 days straight of rain and stuck in camp, just no visibility whatsoever, broken my arm, ended up with surgery. Last year we had a black bear go after the same goat, a golden eagle go after the same goat, and a bush plane next door, an outfitter, flew through and scared off the goat. So, 5th kick of the can, this has got to be it. I have a really, really great feeling. We've got beautiful weather, great horses, absolutely fabulous terrain and country. So our plan is saddle up the horses, head up the valley today to set up a spike camp, and then start glassing for goats. That's our plan. And then hopefully we'll see a really good goat, go after it the next day, and hopefully get it done in a day. That's what most people tell me happens, but it hasn't happened for me yet. So let's see, but I'm really, really excited. Now we carry Yukon Magnum bear spray all the time in bear country, even when we have a rifle. Now if you look at some of the extensive studies out of Alaska, your best odds of surviving a bear attack are with bear spray. Now the great thing about bear spray is rather than escalating a bear attack, like wounding a bear with a rifle can do, it actually diffuses the situation. Now it doesn't hurt the bear, but rather it makes it really uncomfortable for it to be around. Now, one of the biggest myths about bear spray is that you actually have to spray the bear. But the truth is, all you need to do is atomize the spray in front of the bear and then let it breathe it in. There is really no better way to prevent a bear attack. And don't forget, bear spray does have an expiry date. So, what's for supper tonight?
Sheepsteak.
Yeah. With my guide, Matt Lake. Now, you were Canadian bareback champion 2013.
Yeah, and now so, I'm reduced to this.
No, I figure I'm hunting with a celebrity. This is pretty cool.
I think you're the celebrity. Not me.
So we made it to spike camp and went up the hill here and just glassed some of these mountains. We saw a boatload of sheep, or not sheep, sorry, goats.
I've seen sheep too, but yeah. Lots so, of goats, probably 9 or 10 already.
Oh, yeah. They're just popping out everywhere. So, ran out of a bit of light, now it's time for some supper. Get up
sheep steak.
early tomorrow morning and start glassing again. I guess the trick is don't go after anything until we've spotted them and nobody is.
Yeah, I'm not climbing a mountain before I see a goat.
So, good feed of sheep steaks. What are we going to have with the sheep steaks?
Spaghetti and sauce. Yeah.
Okay, sounds good.
I don't know if you knew this, but I went to school as a culinary school.
Oh, wow.
No, I didn't. I'm just kidding. But we did tell our last guy that I did.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we did.
Outdoor Quest TV is brought to you by Zeiss Sport Optics. We make it visible. Hornady, accurate, deadly, dependable. Coeur d'Alene Sporting Goods, home of the Rocky Mountain Rifle. Outdoor Quest TV is brought to you by Silver Willow Taxidermy, capturing the memories. Loa Boots, handcrafted in Europe. Deluxe Wall Tents, built in Canada for Canadian conditions.
So got up to a little bit of rain this morning and it's just starting to clear up, but seen quite a few goats. Got a billy up here, billy over here, two nannies with kids. But I mean, as the weather gets nicer, they should just keep popping out. So it's pretty exciting. And those mountains don't look that nasty. So just keep our eyes on this mountain and see. It's amazing though. We were watching this one billy over here, and he's bedded, and then he stood up, turned around, bedded back down. All you could see was the ear and the spotting scope. So, you know, there could be like 50 goats out there and you'd never see them. And so you just gotta sit, be patient. And once we spot something we really, really like and he beds down, then we'll make a move. But it's only day one, it's pretty exciting. Right, Matt?
Oh yeah.
Well, 10 days aren't that bad in the middle of a hunt, but on the first day of a hunt, they're not that great. But we got a couple hours glassing in this morning and saw lots of goats, quite a few nannies and kids, but a couple potential looking candidates. And then the rain dropped in and just couldn't glass anymore. So we came in and around 1 o'clock, sun came out. It was all beautiful. And Vanessa and I ran up the hill to do a little bit of glassing for about 4 minutes, spotted 7 goats, and then another big rain shower came in, and it hasn't quit since. Just looked at the weather forecast a while ago, and it's supposed to rain all day and all night again, and then weather actually clears up tomorrow, looks like kind of early mid-morning, and should be clear for the rest of the week, so we'll take advantage of this day, I guess, get some rest, even though we don't really need it, and go hard for the next few days when the weather's good.
Well, the Vanessa bad luck continues. We had 27 hours of straight rain yesterday. Never even made it out of the tent except to maybe eat a meal. So rain stopped about 7 o'clock this morning. So we got up and we've been glassing. It's about noon now. And saw lots of goats. We probably saw about 15 goats, mostly nannies and kids that we could make out. So we've kind of checked out this whole face. So we decided it's time to get off our butts, get on those horses, go for a little bit of ride and a little bit of hike, and maybe head out and see some new country and hopefully find a billy for myself. So let's keep my fingers crossed. So we rode up from camp, so we left about, 10 after 1? And it's 2 o'clock right now. Had to do a little bit of trail cleanup on the way up, but found a nice little trail. Hopefully this will take us up to that ridge top that we've been glassing all last 2 days, and get a good look and see. So hopefully there's some billies up there waiting with a 143 grain bullet with its name on it.
We call him Steve.
Steve?
Steve. Steve's waiting.
Why are you calling him Steve?
I don't know. I usually like just...
Just to name your goat?
The last one I sheep we shot, I called him Victor. So this one I'll call Steve.
Okay. So we're looking for Steve.
Right?
We should be looking for Kyle.
Kyle?
Yeah.
No, Kyle's in K country.
Oh, okay.
Outdoor Quest TV is brought to you by Midland Radios. Put yourself in the action. Defense Aerosols, your pepper spray professionals for 25 years.
Well, just hiking up a mountain. It doesn't look, they always look not too bad from afar, but once you get up it, it's been pretty steep. But seen a goat go over the top this morning. I'm just gonna see if we can get up here and get on it. First time up this mountain for me, so we're learning some trails and learning where to go, and if it doesn't work today, we'll have a better idea how things can go for the next one. But weather's cleared up, sat in the tent for too long, so I was ready to hike a mountain, that's for sure.
Do you have rangefinders in those binoculars?
Yeah, but half the time they don't work. I have a rangefinder in my pack. Well, they're working now, though. 660, so 672, I think it is.
So, we made it finally to the top. 3 hours and 10 minutes later. What was it, 2,500?
2,700 feet.
2,700 feet from camp. And there, we're just above a young billy down here. He just disappeared. And we've got a nanny and a kid, and then two other nannies, like a group of four. And we just spotted another one that's just off from them. And it's really, really white, which isn't a great sign for a billy. Billy's, these butts are usually quite dirty. But Matt seems to think that the bases of that guy are much bigger than the one down here. None of them are great to get to. It's 6 o'clock in the evening and we've still got a 3 hour hike back down to where the horses are. So we already know we're facing dark, but we're just trying to sort of make a plan, sort of decide what to do tonight. Possibly head down now, get up really early, climb this mountain yet again tomorrow, and see what's up here again. The curse continues. Okay, after humming and hawing, we spotted another goat, and he was all by himself, and we're pretty sure he's bigger than this billy. He's big-bodied, he's got that big pot belly, he's got a hump. So we're gonna, it's getting late in the evening, we're already gonna be out in the dark, but we're gonna boogie down to the end here, get a better look at him, but we're pretty sure he's a billy, and if so, I'm shooting myself a billy. Okay, one of the things here is I'm shooting at 427 yards. So, going downhill a little bit, so I want to compensate. So I'm going to put the 400 yard crosshair on him. Dialed my scope to 11, which by the ballistic calculator, is what we figured would be perfect. I just want to make sure I am fully comfortable. And basically, well, my rule of thumb is when I remove my hands, the gun doesn't move, but the crosshairs still are where I want them to be, I'm good. So I may fidget for a while here. But this is a really, really important shot.
Outdoor Quest TV is brought to you by Safari Club International Canada, first for hunters. Alberta Outdoorsman Magazine, Alberta's only hunting, fishing, and trapping magazine.
Cam on him.
4:23, so.
He's going down.
Got lots of time. Oh. Neck. That was a hit.
The curse is over.
Oh. It's because he got me.
You must have some amazingly good luck to like battle that curse. Holy, he soaked up the lead. I gotta say, I've been told that before, but
yeah, your first shot was good though. He only went a few feet. Like
he was hurting bad, but yeah. you kind of don't want him to get up and go anywhere either. With it's late, and it's a long drop down there if he really continues on much further. So
yeah. He hung up pretty good, I think, there.
Yeah,
I think so, yeah. So I'd hate to cut this short, but we're going to run out of light soon. I just got to say one real quick thing. This gun earned its place here. This gun saved my ass on a goat hunt where I broke my arm and I thought my season was over. Sorry.
Five goat trips, I'll do that to you.
This gun, I was in a cast, I'd had surgery, I figured my hunting season was over. TJ had this gun built for him, and he's like, it's got low recoil, try it out, see how it works, right? So, went out, managed to shoot an elk at 544 yards, and just a smoking whitetail, and also a doe whitetail. And had an amazing season, all in a cast. But it was thanks to this rifle. So, it earned its way.
So I guess it's not my rifle anymore.
Nope. And I told you I was going to cry when I got my goat.
What are you looking at, Vanessa?
Well, I'm looking at a giant stone sheep ram. And then I got the three goats we spent most of the afternoon looking at. They're going down to their buddy. But that ram is a toad. Why couldn't I have a stone sheep tag in my pocket?
How would that be, shooting a goat and a big ram like that within minutes of each other?
Oh, can you imagine?
You could have shot them 20 yards apart.
Oh my God.
Oh, it's so, like, it comes so far back, you guys, and just...
He's so loopy, hey?
Oh yeah, huge loopy.
Let's get to my goat.
Well, there you go for a hike in the mountains and find a dead goat.
Holy. That's where I shot him from, right?
Yeah.
It's been an adventure to say the least. And we got in here and I was thinking that curse was continued. We had a beautiful day ride in. Blue sky, absolutely gorgeous. That night it started to rain and it rained for 27 hours straight. So today, this morning, it started to clear. We looked at these mountains, we glassed them. We couldn't really see anything. So these guys decided in their wisdom to climb up the mountain. It's now late. 7:35. We have light for probably an hour. And we got to get this goat taken care of and down the mountain and go to camp, where I'm going to split a bottle of Jägermeister that I have been taking on every hunt with these two fine gentlemen. Thank you so much, TJ, and thank you so much, Matt. You guys were awesome. Thanks, Luke, Vince, for sticking with me. Whew. Dad's sweaty. We made it down to the horses. Oh, needed a bite to eat and a big drink of water. Oh, for some reason, we all edited out the straight uphill the whole way. And it's just a killer going downhill all that way with a big heavy pack on. Anyway, before Bacon runs off, he's snorting like crazy over in the corner here. We got our packs back on. It's an hour back to camp. Let these horses go and eat. So. I'll see you back at camp. Mountain goat over the fire, fresh, as of 7 o'clock this evening.
Yeah.
Cheers.
Yeah.
Nothing wrong with that goat.
My dinner at 1 o'clock in the morning.
That's the chewiest tenderloin I've ever had, though.
For more information on this and other great hunts in northern British Columbia, contact Luke Vince at 587-988-2930.
Check us out online at outdoorquesttv.com. And don't forget to follow us on Facebook and Twitter.